Welcome back to the channel. Before we start our next series, we need to learn about world generation. Now, you can't start a world from scratch, but unless you want to build something very, very specific, you should probably just use the random world generator, and I will teach you how. Now, as you see, there are a lot of fields here. World size and towns and win lose by wise, I tend to max those and minimize the others, because I like to have it easy when I travel between POIs. Same with mountains, I reduce those, so it's easier to travel. As for the biomes, I usually leave them alone, because I want to have at least one big city in every biome. But if you want to reduce or remove a biome, or several biomes, you can actually do that. You can have one biome on the whole map. Then you click Generate World, and after 8, 10, 15 minutes, depending on your PC, a new world will be ready. Now, here's the map, and just wait for the machine to populate. There you go. Yeah, at least one big city in every biome. Wasteland in the middle, that's pretty normal. Yeah. Looks okay. A lot of big cities in the forest biome. It'll be easy to start up, probably. Here is a list of all the POIs and their positions on the map we just generated. Old players will recognize these names from back when we didn't have names on buildings, like Skyscraper 02 would be Crackerbook Headquarters, Bookstore would be Crackerbook, etc., etc. So if you have a favorite POI, you can look it up here and check that it's on the map, probably several times, to be honest, on a big map like this. And here's a list of all the POIs and their new names. Bravo 21 also has a lot of important information, like you can see zombie population. Let's search for Skyscraper 02. And if you scroll down, you will also see all the zombies that you can find on this POI. Not important for world generation, but useful for new players. Okay, let's look at one more. Chemi Factory. It's a pretty big POI. Tier 5, of course. As you can see, there's a lot of info. A lot of zombies. And a lot of loot. Again, not important, but now you know. Okay, let's talk about seeds. So there are billions upon billions of possible maps you can get using the random map generator. But not all of them are good. Luckily, 7 Days to Die has a big player community that are actually not toxic. And they will share information with other people, like maps they found. If you try using a world seed, here, Wacky Folketing, that's a world seed for medium maps. I know it's good on medium, don't know about big. Let's try that and let it run for 15 minutes, and we get this map here. So every time there's a new edition of 7 Days to Die, which has been running for 10 years in alpha, there will be players sharing information online. There will be people running computers over the night, running scripts, finding a lot of seeds, and managing a lot of information. And we will share seeds between one another, and good maps and settings. You can find that if you search the community on Steam, for example. Or YouTube, like I'm doing now. Here's the results. So this map is totally different from the last one. Now I wouldn't play with this because I don't like the wasteland part. Also, the desert city is way up north. And there are so many maps that will be better than this. let's just move on and take another shot at it. Okay, that's the map. Let's see the cities. No. I don't much care for the snow and desert part, because I really like one big city in each biome. So this one isn't for me. Okay, let's do another one. Okay, and population, please. Yeah, that one was much better. It's hard to get the wasteland right. Okay, this one I got from a tip. So this was going to be a very good world on a big map. Most people like to play medium, but I like them big. Okay, let's see what we get. Interesting. Yeah, I already knew this map was going to be good because I got a tip, but here you can see there are at least one big city, several has two in every biome. I think this looks very interesting. I would like to play this map sometime because I already heard that it was pretty good to play, so yeah. I'll keep this one in the backlog. Now, if you are like me and you like the bigger ones, you should probably check out the other generators, like the nitrogen ones. They will make maps for up to 16k. That's almost twice the size. There's also people who custom fit worlds. There's a mega city option. Somebody made a map entirely filled with buildings. And there are people who use real life maps and fill them with buildings. That's also an option. But if you like the medium maps, I will conclude this video with a list of seeds you can use that will be good for medium. But again, it depends on your settings. Feel free to try it out. If you think, if you haven't tried this yet and your computer seems to freeze, just leave it. It's not frozen. Just keep it running for a while. If you have a really bad computer, maybe 30 minutes. I think 10 minutes is normal. Yeah, I'll see you in Yakuza territory. If you want to join me, use the Robin seed. And that concludes the lesson.